So we'll be starting second module from this video. First topic in second module is list. So here list is a data type where multiple values is stored in the list in an ordered sequence. So list always starts with open square brace and ends with closed square brace, and multiple data is stored in the list one after the other by separating comma. If it is string, then we have to write inside a single quote. If it is list, can also save multiple types of data like string, integer, floating values, everything which is separated by comma. And inside list item means in the values inside the list is called as items. So the list data type, here is the example. So this is the example of list where 1, 2, 3 is one list and cat, bat, rat, elephants are one more list, and we can assign the list to a data variable name like spam equal to data values or list values. And if you give spam, all the values inside the list will be printed, getting our individual values in the list with indexing. So here, like our arrays in previous programming languages, we can get the values of list with indexing. If we have spam and cat, bat, rat, elephant as the list values, so first value of spam is with index 0 and we can fetch it with spam flower like square brace 0 index and close the brace. If I type spam 0 in the IDLE shell, then it prints the value at 0th index and 1, 2, 3 and so on. And if you are using string concatenation with plus, then we can make use of spam index. Make sure that it should have index which is having a string. So if it is having string value, then it can be concatenated with one more string. So that can be done in between the string as well. Next one is list with individual indexing, invalid indexing. So if you have a list of four elements or four values in it, if you give fifth value or more than fifth values, then there will be a error generated called list index out of range. Means the indexing what you are getting here, spam is 1000, then the list is out of range here. Next, if you are giving the list index with 1.0, which is like you are giving a value with floating or decimal values, then it also generates a indexing where not float values are taken for indexing. You can anyhow give integer function like int function, which is converting your float values to integer, which is acceptable. Next one is getting individual like invalid values in a list with indexes. So we have a list that can be having multiple list in it, like not only a list contains only one list, a list can be having multiple list inside one list. Like spam equal to cat, bat is one list and it is considered as one value for spam, and next indexing has multiple values. So here you can have index with 0, which gives you complete one list, or if you want to fetch one value from list and which is having one more list, then we have to make use of two indexing. So cat, bat is in list 0 index and cat comes in 0th index of 0th index. So 0 is for cat, 0, 1 for bat. So if I give 0, 1, the bat value is printed. If I give 1, then the index with 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 is indexed. And if I give specific index inside like 1, 4, so 1th index is this list, and inside 1 we have 4th index as 50. 40 has 3, 30 has 2, 20 has 1 and 10 has 0. So this is about indexing with multiple indexes for the list. Next one is negative indexing. If you are giving positive index from 0 to 1 to 3, then 0 is for cat, bat, then 1 for bat, 2 for rat, 3 for elephant. But if you give minus 1, then the indexing starts from last to first. Minus 1 is elephant, minus 2 is rat, minus 3 is bat, and minus 4 is cat. So this is how negative indexing work in list. Negative indexing in the list is valid and it fetches the values from back side to front or right to left category. Getting sublists with slices, like instead of accessing one value in the list, we can access more than a value from the list, if which concept means this concept is called as slices. So slices, in the sense, you can give two indexes or two integers in one call for the value with like separation with colon. So if I take a example here, spam, the same spam example, cat, bat, rat, elephant. If I give 0 to 4, so 0th index is cat and 4th index is, there is no 4th index here, but it is accessing till the 3rd index, means 0 to 4 in the sense 0, 1, 2, 3, it has 4 values. From 0, 4 values. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So it has 4 values. So cat, bat, rat, elephant is fetched. 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2. So it is taking 1, 2 values, not 3rd value. Means like our array indexing, where it was fetching till n minus 1, same way it is fetching till the value, second values minus 1. 1, 2. 1 and 2 means 1 to 2 has 2 values in between. Like 0 to minus 1, 0th value is cat, minus 1 value is elephant. So 0 to minus 1, you are getting values of cat, bat, and rat. And this is how sublisting or slicing happens in list. And we have one more category called leaving out second index. If you leave out second index, means if you are having only one index but it has still colon. So first index is empty but you have second indexing, then first index is considered as 0. If you leave second index but if you specify first index, then last index is specified with last value of the string, sorry, of the list. So if it is 1 to empty, then first value is bat, second, third, if you have fourth, fifth, till the end of the list is printed. If you take spam only colon, then it lists all the elements from the list. Next one is getting list length with len. So spam, cat, dog, mouse is our list. If you want to find the length of the string, no need to go count using for loop or something, but there is one function called len function. If you pass an argument to the len function with the name of the data types list, like list name, then it gives you the length of the list directly. Len is passed with function name, sorry, len is passed with an argument of list name. Then the list, what you are specifying with len function, its length is specified. Next one is changing value in the list with indexing. So here, if you take a list with number of elements and, sorry for that, if you take number of elements in the list and you want to change the index of the list, means if you want to change the value of the list to another value, then go to list with the index and specify with equals and give the next value what you want. So in the place of spam 1 we had bat, but after assignment of operation to spam 1, that the value what you were changing, then the next spam, like spam list, will be updated with cat to the value what you have given next, and spam 2 is equal to spam 1. That also works. The spam value will be changed like this. So next, with negative index, we can even use positive index, negative index to change the values of the list. With the assignment value, you can change the value. It is like changing, if it is a equal to 1 and if you want to change a equal to 10, a equal to 10